First came the most vulnerable. This infant has been lifted onto a truck by members of the French gendarmerie. As Hurricane Tomas made landfall in Haiti on the 4th of November, the International Organization for Migration conducted an emergency evacuation from the Corail-Cesselesse camp.
You can see behind me, we are trying to move first the children, women and the elder people.
Elle voulait pas se déplacer parce que elle vit avec son mari et le mari était. Donc elle a décidé de rester, mais à côté de sa volonté de rester toute seule dans la tente, elle a envoyé ses enfants.
The move went smoothly as the evacuation center was only a few kilometers from the Corail camp. The families are well organized and they divide themselves into the same groups that live together in the camps. Here's some fast food bought from a roadside stall. Children find ways to amuse themselves amid all the excitement of the move. These youngsters are offering a tour of the facilities to some IOM staff. This woman says she's happy to have a roof over her head in the driving rain, even if the conditions could be improved. Luca Deloglio, IOM's chief of mission, makes an inspection prior to a food distribution.
The WFP truck has brought some food and they're trying to put it in the IOM trucks because we can then do the distribution easily. Peut-être deux pour chacun. Oui, je crois qu'il y a deux pour chacun.
On the second night of the evacuation, with the worst of the danger past, this camp leader says it's time to go home to Corail. Later in the evening, some delinquents created a panic in the evacuation center by shouting earthquake. Many of the evacuated then walked or were transported back to their camp in Corail. And by mid-morning, the Old Duvalier hospital stood empty, just as it has been for the last 20 years.